Hey, in this video, I'm gonna give you an introduction and overview of one of the most important design stages, wireframing. I'll discuss what wireframing is, why it's used, and how you can start building the structure of your first UI design. I'm Elizé, an Adobe XD instructor, and I've been doing UX UI since 2015. My goal is to make design education fun and exciting through my content and speaking engagements. I also make fun and educational content on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, and LinkedIn. By the end of this video, you'll have a better understanding of wireframing, and you'll also have some sketches that you can carry on to the next exercise. If you have any questions on wireframing or anything that we're covering in this design series, please feel free to leave it in the comments below and we'll answer as soon as possible. If you want more content like this from Career Foundry, just subscribe and hit the bell to be notified of new videos. This video is part of Career Foundry's free UI short course. If you'd like to follow along with the lesson plans, just go ahead and click the free sign up link in the description below. Let's dive in and get started. So first, what is a wireframe? Consider the role of an architect. Before they start designing a beautiful home with granite countertops and a white picket fence, they need to create a two-dimensional blueprint of the structure for the home. This blueprint will help them visualize where the entrance and exit points are, the direction people will walk in, and how each room will be best utilized. It's a functional jumping off point for the rest of the house's design. Think of a wireframe as a blueprint for digital products. Wireframes provide a clear overview of the page's structure, layout, information architecture, user flows, as well as intended behaviors. These are done during the early stages of the product's lifecycle. All the fancy stuff like colors, typography, images are omitted at this stage so that you can just focus on the core screen elements. And these can be hand-drawn or created by a digital tool. So let's talk about the value of wireframing. Getting honest feedback. You can show it to stakeholders to start getting some feedback really early on and see, are you going in the right direction? Or is there some input that's really critical at this stage? You can also share this with users as well and discover some pain points that allow you to make some smart decisions when you're iterating upon your design. Wireframing allows you to also do some self-critiques. Once you start laying things out on a screen, you can be like, oh, okay, maybe this is a little too cluttered, or maybe I'm missing some critical key elements on the screen. It's also cheap and fast. If you have a paper and a pen, you can start wireframing without spending a penny. This is the easiest way to test your designs without spending a whole lot of time and money. The further you go along with your design and the more you put into it, the more you get attached to it too, the harder it is to make iterations and changes. Let's talk about the different types of wireframes. Low fidelity is done in the very early stages, and basic shapes are more than enough to show the basic hierarchy of elements on a screen. This can be done with paper and pen or with a digital tool as well. These are also typically done in gray scale, so black, white, gray, no colors at this point. The next stage is medium fidelity, and this is when you're feeling pretty comfortable with the content's overall structure. You'll definitely be moving on to a digital tool at this point, and you're gonna be a little bit more detailed in your copy. You might be adjusting the sizes of the components, perhaps adding a little bit of images at this point as well. The final stage is high fidelity screens. And this is the point where you're feeling really confident and good about your designs. You've showed it to stakeholders, other team members. You may have done some user testing as well. And this is when you're gonna add the colors, typography, images, all those branded elements to make it look like what it's going to actually feel like when it's live. Let's review a little bit of mobile design best practices. If you're doing any sort of responsive design, I highly recommend doing your desktop as well as mobile at the same time. Remember that your user is going to need to tap on a mobile device with ease. So you want to think about the sizing of each element. Each element, whether it's a button or a dropdown, needs to be large enough to accommodate the fingertip. Also, there needs to be enough space surrounding it so that the user is not accidentally tapping on something else. This is referred to as touch targets, which we'll be reviewing tomorrow. Now let me introduce you to some UI elements. UI elements are the building blocks used to create apps and websites. They're individual parts that provide touch points that guide the user throughout the different pages. There are four main categories of UI elements. Number one, input controls. Number two, navigational components. Number three, informational components. And number four, containers. Let's look at these a little more closely. Input controls allow users to input information into the system. These can be forms, buttons, dropdowns, etc. Navigational components allow a user to navigate an app or website. These can include a hamburger menu or a tap bar. Informational components share information with the user, so something like a pop-up box or a progress bar. And containers just hold content together. Now it's time for the fun part, creating our first wireframes. For this task, you'll need a pen or pencil and some paper. And honestly, any paper is fine as long as you can see your sketches clearly. When drawing your first wireframe, think about that first impression you want your users to have. A few things to consider are how big do you want your buttons and where do you want your logo? Also, do you want your imagery to fill up the whole screen or just half the screen? Make sure you're sketching everything, so title, subtitle, even the words on the buttons. And if you mess up, don't worry. This is the time to do it. Go ahead and make as many rough sketches as you need in order to feel confident and happy with your designs. Now, it might not look so nice. You do not have to be a great drawer, but this wireframe will serve as your reference point when you start designing your digital screens. Once you're done, go ahead and put it somewhere safe, maybe take a picture of it, and we'll refer back to it in tomorrow's video. And with that, it's a wrap for day two. Wireframing may seem really simple and basic, but we need this structure before we can move on to some of the more fun stuff like colors and typography. Understanding the wireframing process is such an important aspect of the design process. So it's really important to get into the habit of sketching out your ideas first. So hopefully this video has given you a better understanding of wireframing and its importance in the design process. This was lesson two in CareerFoundry's free UI short course. Sign up via the link in the description below. If you've already signed up for the short course and you're watching this in the tutorial pages, make sure to keep reading the tutorial page for this topic. You'll find more information and tips. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the like button and subscribe to see more UX UI content like this. And if you have any questions on user interface design or any of the video topics, please feel free to leave it in the comments below and we will get back to you as soon as possible. In the next video, I'll detail how to start creating shapes in Adobe XD, how to build out the digital framework for our product, and how to create a logo. See you then.